Hello, welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, I'll be replacing the bearings on the bottom and the top pulley spindles for the lathe drive system. This is one of the bearings, and I'll show you how to replace them in this video.
Okay, this is the bottom of the Boxford lathe where the motor is. And I've got a problem with something rattling, I can't find out what it is. But the first thing obviously is turn the power off, disconnect this tensioning mechanism. Nut and bolt on this side, and a nut and bolt on that side, and the motor unit at the bottom should come out. Again. The nut on this side. And slacken off the bolt. These two bolts are under the shaft, so I can't get the socket on it. And that should move. Just the motor on its own. I'll get this cleaned out. Now I can get at it. Leave the label. Two ceramic connector blocks with a sponge behind it. See how they've identified it. All the wires are white and pink. So basically we've got a white and a pink and a white and a pink on this side. And on this side they've just stuck some red tape on to denote that these two go together. Undo it from the cable side. That should pull the wires through. At this, I've cleaned the motor down. I've just sprayed it with some degreaser and wiped it over. This is the electric motor. It's a Compton Parkinson motor, AC motor, 220 volts to 240, single phase, 0.75 horsepower, and I think it does 1,425 revs per minute. Looking at it, I can't see anything wrong with it. It works okay. So all I'm going to do on this is clean it up a bit, take the cover off and check the bearings have got grease in. But as you can see from that, it's revolving freely. There's nothing catching, there's no noise. So I'll just check that it's got grease in. And also I'll check that this pulley's tight on that. That's tight. That's tight, doesn't need to be. Can't feel any play in it. I'm quite happy with that motor. I'll just turn it round, take the back cover off here and see what I'll take, the grease looks all right as well. I'm going to take that out and repack it. I've repacked the grease. Put the cover back on. And that ends are okay. Rotating freely, so I don't think there's anything wrong with the motor. So I'll put the motor back on the floor and I'll get the carriage that it fits in. What happens is the electric motor drives the belt, which turns this side, and this is the five different speeds you can have on this side. So there's another belt that goes on here that goes up to a spindle that goes across the top. The only thing I've noticed is that this pulley on this end, there's a bit of play in this pulley on this end. Take the shaft off the base plate, and I've noticed there's grease that's gone hard on the face here. Clear the grease off here, clean this off and bolt that back to the motor. I've taken off the pulley on the motor side. I've taken the woodruff key out of the shaft, which goes in there. I've cleaned all this down. Spin the bearing. It sounds as if there's no grease in the bearing. I think what's happened is the grease has escaped somehow. But it sounds like new bearings needed on that. You can hear it's a bit. I had to drill the grub screw out on this end because trying to undo it, it was bending the Allen key and for some reason it was jammed in. Okay, let's bring you up to date with what's happened. Started to reassemble the motor and the holders. I've bolted the frame to the top of the motor. Cleaned it down. The bearings have arrived. I've cleaned the original holders. These are KSM bearings. I thought there'd be some sort of cheap replacement, but they're actually made in Japan, so the quality should be okay. Let's just check that they are the same. First job I'll do is just tap them into the housings. Okay, I've pressed the first bearing into the housing. The way I did that was you put the bearing into the housing square, put it into the vise with drill protectors and pushed it in till it comes to the front. And using a big socket, which is just smaller than the OD of the bearing, use that to hold it between the vise and push it in all the way home. Just file the flat on this end a bit further along. Grub screw was going onto the edge of the flat rather than on the flat itself. You see now I've just taken the flat back about a quarter of an inch past where that hole was. That's where the pulley is going to clamp on, so I can use the hole for the grub screw to locate in, and I know that pulley is in exactly the same position as it was before. Now I found a piece of tube that just fits over the bearing. The next thing I've done is put the woodruff key, and I did that just by putting some vise jaw protectors on and just using the vise to squash it back into the slot. So all that remains now is to put the pulley on. I'm just tapping the pulley on. I've got a block of wood on the end of the pulley holding the shaft in the vise with some lead jaw protectors, and just tap. I've pushed the pulley on until it lines up. You can just see in the bottom of the hole where the drill went through. I just spotted the flat. Cleaned out the area, wiped down the oil and grease off the sides, and cleaned the floor so it's ready to go back in.
Now while I've got this empty, I've decided to replace the bearings in the top shaft. All I need to do here is undo the four bolts for the bearing holders, slide the belts off, and I can take the bearing holders off the end of the shaft and replace the bearings in the same way as I did on the main shaft.
The bearings have arrived for the top shaft. Part number R12ZZ, KSM, Japanese bearings again. I've just got to press these into the holders, press them onto the shaft and bolt the shaft back onto the machine. I've also got a new drive belt because I thought the other belt was a bit stiff. Should be enough adjustment on the length to take up an inch or two on the diameter, but that was the nearest size I could get to the existing one that I had. I've used the socket again, which goes on the outside of the bearing, to press it home. I think I've turned it round in the vise. I've got some lead jaw protectors on the vise to stop it damaging the shaft. So both bearings are up against the face. That's ready now to go back into the lathe. When putting the shaft back in, the first job is to put the main drive belt from the headstock onto the centre pulley and put the speed change belt onto the pulley before you bolt the spindle there. And if you slide the spindle in under the bracket, that just puts a little bit of tension on the centre belt. So what I need to do now is put the four nuts and bolts back in and then align the belt by pushing it backwards and forwards to get it back in similar position to it was before. I've put the bolts in loosely. You can't move it left or right, so that lines up with the brackets, but you can push it backwards and forwards. And all I'm doing is bringing it forward on each bearing housing so I know that it's square. And also I've checked that the belt, your headstock belt, is clear where it goes through the lathe base. There's a slot, so you want to make sure that the belt's not running up against the lathe cabinet, and that's clear. So now all I've got to do is tighten the four bolts up and put the pulley on the drive. So once you've put your assembly back together, just recheck that the belts are still in line. Now I'll override the safety switch and see how it runs. Let's change it up. Speed. This belt's not worn in yet. Drop it down to the midway. You see, I've hardly got any tension on there at all. Just a to...
Well, I hope you found that interesting, and if you did, why not give me the thumbs up or subscribe, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.